you all are fine at home. So student, we have already completed our lesson number 1, nutrition in plants. So today we are going to chapter number 2, that is nutrition in animals. This is video of grade 7, lesson number 2, part 1. So students, we in previous video we saw that plants are making their own food by themselves. This process is called as a photosynthesis. So this process needs water, carbon dioxide, some amount of nutrition and sunlight. So plant is converting carbon dioxide into the oxygen. This process is called as a photosynthesis process. So students, in plants also having two types. One is the autotroph, another one is a heterotroph. So what is mean by autotroph? Autotroph, it means auto, it means self. Heterotroph means nutrition. And it means those plants are making their own food by themselves. This process is called as the autotrophic plants. Another is the heterotroph. Hetero, it means other, nutrition. So means that plants are not making their own food by themselves. They are depend on host plant. This plants are called as a heterotrophic plants. So students, today we are going to solve that where, how and when we get or animals get the nutrition from plants as well as insects or some types of animals. So you have learned in chapter number 1 that plant can prepare their own food by process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, it means plant make their own food. But animal cannot, because human being is also one type of social animal, or human being is also depend on directly or indirectly on plants. So animals get their food from plants either directly by eating plants or indirectly by eating animals that eat plants. In animals also having three types, herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous animal. So herbivorous, it means that plant animals are eating only plants. Carnivorous, it means that plant animals are eating other small animals. And omnivorous, it means such type of animals are depend on plants as well as in animals also. So some animals eat both plant and animal. Recall that all organisms include humans require food for growth, repair and functioning of the body. So all human beings can need food. Yes, because from food we are getting various type of nutrition like carbon dioxide, fats, proteins, carbohydrates. So human beings need food for daily activities, for proper growth, for repair. So animals' nutrition includes nutrient requirement, mode of intake of food and its utilization in the body. So same as in animals also, because some animals are depend on plants. So they are eating plants and they are converting their energy into the fats. Have you studied in class 6 that food consists of many components? Try to recall and list them below. So you in grade 6 you already learned, and very few minutes I have recalled that from food we are getting, you have to write in this column. Okay. So whenever this video is going on, you have to take your pencil and eraser with you. If you find some difficult words, so while I am reading or while you are reading, you have to put an underline. And this activity purpose you need pencils. So whenever you have to start the video of science, you have to take your pencil in your hand. So have you studied in class 6? How many types of components are present into the food? So first you can write carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and various types of minerals are present into the food. So the component of food such as carbohydrates are complex substances. Carbohydrates down our food, or we have to break down the carbohydrates. Complex substances, it is like a chain. Okay, it like a chain, but we have to convert into the simpler substance, simple formation we converge karna hai. Then and then you can digest the such type of foods. So they are broken down into a simpler substance. The breaking down of complex substance of this is complex substance diagram, and this is a simpler structure diagram. So food into a simpler substance is called as a digestion. When complex structure is converted into simpler substance, so this process is called as a digestion. Different ways, 2.1, different ways to taking of food. So in human being we have two hands, mouth. In mouth also having various type of teeth. So we are taking food by eating. Okay, हम खाना eating करके खाते हैं. Okay, we are eating. Suppose you want to drink juice, so you are sucking the juice. You have to suck juice. Okay, then sometimes means suppose various type of fruits are there, some juices are there, some foods are there. We are taking that food in various type. Okay, so everyone having the eating habit. सबकी एक अलग eating habit होती है in animals, human beings. In animals also having some different animals. They having their own eating habit. Some mosquitoes are there. They having a different type of eating habit or different type of mouth parts like that. So we have to see that. I think you previously you learned that in human being having various type of thing. What type of eating habits having some insects or animals or plants or human being. So students, the mode of taking food into the various type of different organisms. Every animal having different type of mode of food taking. So bees and hummingbirds suck the nectar of the plants. Infants of human are many mother feed on the mother's milk. Now bees and hummingbird. Bees and hummingbirds, what they are doing? Sucking. What they are doing? Sucking the nectar from the plants. So sucking, it means they having their feeding habit. Ye hummingbird ki aur bees ki fooding habit hai, khane ka tarika hai. To wo kaise khate hai? By sucking. Then infants means chote bacche. They are depend on their mother's milk. Yes, they are depend on their mother's milk. So they are also taking mother's milk by feeding. Use feeding kehte hain. To feeding it means they are sucking. Then many other animals are snakes like a python. Snake like a python. Python is a one category of animal. So python is solo the animals they prey upon. They are swallow it means puri tarah nigal jana. To python hota hai wo uski eating habit hai. Python kya karta hai? They are swallowing their whole animal. Usko jab bhook lagti hai aur jab wo uske prey ko catch karta hai, prey matlab shikar, jab usko wo shikar milta hai usko kya karta hai? Pura nigal jata hai. उसे कहा जाता है swallowing. Then some aquatic animals flitted teeny food particle floating nearby and they feed upon them. और जो aquatic animals होते हैं वो feed करते हैं, feeding करते हैं. So in such type of animals having in various animals having different animals having different habit, eating habits. Okay, now activity 2.1. So in activity 2.1, having various type of examples, you have to write their mode of food, kind of food, and mode of feeding. Kind of food and mode of feeding. So in first column, kind of food means वो क्या खाते थे, and mode of feeding it means वो कैसे खाते थे. That table you have to complete. I will complete few examples and snail eating. Snail is eating some insects and leaves. So how she is eating or how it is eating? वो कैसे खाती है? So mode of eating of insect is scraping. Scraping means तोड़ तोड़ के खाती है. It is called as a scraping. So snail is eating insect and some type of leaves. How she is eating? By scraping. Another example is ant. Ant मतलब चींटी. चींटी कैसे खाती है? So what is ant eating? Ant is also eating various type of food. Okay. So food, but mode of feeding of ant is chewing. Chewing मतलब चबाना. Ant is eating their own food by chewing. Next is the eagle. What is eagle eating? Small animals like snakes, rats, frog. So eagle is eating snakes, rat, fox. How she is eating? So mode of eating habit of eagle is swallowing. Swallowing मतलब पूरी तरह निगल जाना. Swallowing. Next is hummingbird. Hummingbird. What is hummingbird? Is it? We already saw an example. Hummingbird. Hummingbird is sucking nectar from the plants. Hummingbird is sucking nectar from the flower. So mode of feeding is sucking. Okay. Now you have to complete 1, 2, 3, 4. That is first is lice. Lice is with head louse. Head louse with the jewel. Second is mosquito. Mosquito मतलब मच्छर. Then butterfly, you know, तितली. And next is the housefly. Housefly मतलब मक्खी जो अपनी normal रूप में. Then you have to write the kind of food and mode of the feeding. So students, next is we already saw these examples. Okay. So next is first you have to complete this table. Take a capture or take a photo, and if you have any problem, then WhatsApp me on my personal number. So next is amazing fact. Amazing fact means बहुत कुछ अच्छा means surprising जो हमको कभी नहीं पता होती है ऐसी चीजें. Amazing fact. So amazing fact. You saw this beautiful diagram? Yes, this is beautiful diagram of starfish. Starfish मतलब उसका जो shape होता है वो कैसा होता है? Star जैसा होता है. So this diagram is of starfish. So starfish feeds on animals covered by hard shell of calcium carbonate. Starfish का जो ऊपरी परत होती है बहुत hard होती है. It is made up of calcium carbonate like our teeth. तो वो teeth जैसे hard shell से उसकी body जो होती है वो covered होती है. After opening the shell, the starfish pops out its stomach through its mouth to eat a soft animal inside the shell. जब वो उसका mouth open करता है, तो एकदम small and delicate insect inside होता है. Then the stomach cup then goes back into the body and food is slowly digested. वो उसका stomach बाहर निकल के खाना खा लेता है. And after वो खाना खाने के बाद that shell is closed. Shell जो होता है वो बंद हो जाता है और फिर उसके बाद उसकी digestion की process start होती है. Students, our next topic number 2.2 is digestion of humans. So digestion in human. So your homework is that you have to read digestion in human body. You have to read each and every topic. Then whenever the video part 2 will you see, then you having some ideas what ma'am is going to teach us. So student, today for it's only. If you have any queries, then ask me in our WhatsApp session. So thank you so much.
Human digestive system. What is meant by digestion, absorption, and defecation? The conversion of food into simple soluble forms is known as Digestion. After digestion, food is absorbed by the body. This is called absorption. The unabsorbed food is thrown out of the body in the form of feces. This process is known as defecation. The digestive system in our body consists of the mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver, gallbladder, and pancreas. Mouth. When animals take in food, we say they are feeding. The mouth is the entrance of the digestive tract. The mouth contains tongue, teeth, and salivary glands. When the food is taken in the mouth, the tongue, jaws, and teeth work together in grinding the food. So digestion of food begins in the mouth. While chewing, you feel a watery liquid being secreted in your mouth. This is saliva, which is secreted by the salivary glands. There are three pairs of salivary glands in the mouth. Saliva helps in the digestion of food. Teeth. The teeth cut and grind the food to break it down into smaller particles. All of us have two sets of teeth in our lifetime. The first one we have from the time when we are babies until we are about 6 years old. These are known as milk teeth or temporary teeth. When milk teeth fall out, permanent teeth take their place. There are 32 teeth in all, 16 in each jaw. There are four types of teeth in our mouth. These are called incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Incisors. These are found in front of the mouth. They are chisel-shaped and mainly used for biting and cutting. Canines. These are pointed and used for piercing and tearing pieces of food. Premolars. These are two on each side of each jaw. These teeth have flat surfaces bearing small grooves and ridges. These are adapted to crush and grind the food. Molars. These are the last three teeth on both sides in both the jaws. They have flat surfaces with small projections for effective grinding of the food. Tongue. Tongue is the organ used for taste. It contains taste buds to distinguish whether a type of food is sweet, sour, bitter, or salty. It also helps in rolling and pushing the food into the pharynx. It mixes the saliva with the food. The process of chewing of food during which it mixes with saliva is known as mastication. Esophagus. It is the passage of food between the mouth and the stomach. While swallowing the food, a flap called epiglottis prevents it from entering the lungs and choking us. Through the esophagus, food reaches the stomach. Stomach. The stomach is a bag-like structure. In the stomach, the food is mixed with the gastric juices secreted by the gastric glands of the stomach. Gastric juice converts the food into a semi-solid state called chyme. Small intestine. From the stomach, the food enters the small intestine. It is the longest part of the digestive system. It is a coiled tube and is about 6 meters in length. It consists of three parts, namely duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. In the small intestine, the food is mixed with bile juice and the pancreatic juice. These are secreted by the liver and pancreas respectively. Both these juices help in digestion. Some substances cannot be digested. These materials are passed into the large intestine. Large intestine. The large intestine is thicker but smaller in length than the small intestine. It consists of three parts, namely cecum, colon, and rectum. It helps in absorbing water and in removing undigested solid waste from the body in the form of feces, which is stored in the lower part of the large intestine called rectum. It is sent out from the body through the anus by a process called defecation.